Yeah, we all know that song. It's been performed by different artists, but, you know, Rockin' Robin Roberts with the Wailers was the first to record Richard Berry's Louie Louie. He revised the original Jamaican theme version, spinning it into his own rock style, then ad-libbed into the arrangement that, yeah, 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 oh, 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 oh.
Yeah, 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 oh.
Now let's get it to me right now, something like that.
No, let's give it to her right now!
Anyway, he was born Lawrence Roberts II in New York City in 1940. The only child, like me, and he was raised in Queens. His father was an architect, but unfortunately, he died unexpectedly when he was young. So Robin and his mother moved to Tacoma, Washington to start over. In high school, Robin came off as sort of an oddball, like ultra brainy, nerd type, an honor roll student who would serve as his school's science club secretary, German club vice president, and the PTA and Red Cross representative. He also fancied himself as a singer of R&B and rock and roll. And when he was just 14 years old, he went over to the county fair, where he bravely stood up on a bench and loudly sang a Little Richard song for the whole crowd, a cappella. And among those fairgoers happened to be a couple of fellow teenagers who had recently formed their own band called the Blue Notes. So they end up inviting Robins to join. Things start off great. They're doing bookings, good gigs, but Robin was a full-time student and the Blue Notes already had a lead singer. So with this and that, contention started to grow over time between the vocalists. And eventually, Robin felt sidelined due to some public appearance decisions. So he ended up leaving, and a few months later, he joined their rival local band, the Wailers. But it was Robin who took Richard Berry's original melody and transformed it into the garage rock prototype that we all know and boogie down to. He recorded the song when he was just 21 years old in 1961. And 2 years later, it became a big hit for a little band out of Portland, Oregon, called the Kingsmen, who swiped Robin's original arrangements. I'd like to have known what Robin thought about that. Anywho, Robin's discography contained a total of just 6 songs, all recorded with the Wailers and released on Etiquette Records, which he helped the band establish. I'm telling you, this young man seized every day. He was such an electric dynamo on stage with an extraordinary voice, and he gave an exhilarating experience for anyone who came and saw him perform. He was one hell of an entertainer. He would jump up on top of the piano during a sax solo, dance around, and then leap off and grab the mic again from the sax stand and continue singing, like never missing a beat. And that's how he picked up the nickname, Rockin' Robin. Not only was Robin a dynamic singer with a great stage presence, but he was also a highly intelligent scholar with a passion for science. He ended up getting a master's in biochemistry and later moved to San Francisco to work as a chemist. Sadly, in 1967, Robin Roberts died in a terrible and horrific accident 3 days before Christmas in San Mateo. He was killed on impact in a head-on automobile accident after leaving a party with his co-workers around 1 in the morning. He was in a car traveling the wrong way on the freeway south of San Francisco. And that created a 7-car pileup. It was really, really bad. A car went up in flames. Another passenger in another car died. It was terrible. He and the driver both died at the scene. What a talented young man he was. So accomplished at just 27 years old. Gone too soon.
Jamaica, I'm on a bomb.